Hey folks, Joseph Sobora here. It's clean. It's cool. Now that's what I call high quality H2O. Yes, I'm talking about the movie The Waterboy. The Adam Sandler comedy, that was a hit, that came out, hard to believe, 20 years ago. Actually came out on November 6, 1998, which earns from its $23 million budget out of $186 million at the box office. Yeah. But what'd you expect? It may be silly, dumb, moronic, but you know what? I don't care. It's a wacky comedy, and it's also a sports comedy, and it could definitely be an anti-bullying film that I appreciate it. But you know, I love Adam Sandler ever since the Saturday Night Live days. I watch his comedies, you know, ever since I was a kid, of course. You know, just before, you know, he started to do some really bad films like Jack and Jill, Grown Ups 2, Just Go With It, Blended, and even those crappy Netflix films. So, to me, this was the real deal. But I've been a fan ever since. I think this, to me, in my opinion, it's actually one of the funniest, hilarious comedies I've ever seen. It's right up there with The Wedding Singer, as well as Billy Madison, Happy Gilmore. Yeah. As well as Big Daddy and Little Nicky. And yes, on top of that, even the remake of The Longest Yard, which Sandler also did. But I enjoy this one, so. The Blu-ray, of course, is bare bones. There's no features, which is a shame because the DVD did actually had it. It had a featurette. I think there was a music video included. I could be wrong. But that's pretty much it. And they could have ported this on this release as well. So what can you do? Of course. And then, of course, has the sticker label. HD picture, HD sound. Plays on Blu-ray players and PlayStation 3. You know, just to go old school. And, well, did have artwork in it. I just got to take the disc out. And Bobby Boucher and Bicky Valancourt. Both played by Adam Sandler and Fairuza Balk. Yeah. Okay, I'm just gonna put this away. Anyway, just putting this away. But anyway, it has a great cast too, besides Sandler and Fairuza Balk, you know, from The Craft and Return to Oz. You also got Henry Winkler from Happy Days, as well as Scream. You got Kathy Bates from Misery. Yep. And this is actually one of her finest performances. And you even got Blake Clark from Home Improvement and several others he's been in. So can't go wrong with that. And even has some cameos and other actors joining in. So it's a football comedy that you appreciate it, especially when you drink it with nice, cold, high-quality H2O. Yeah, water. Anyway, the movie stars Adam Sandler, Kathy Bates, Henry Winkler, Fairuza Balk, Jerry Reed, Peter Dante, Larry Gillard Jr., Blake Clark, Jonathan Loughran, Clint Howard, yes, Ron Howard's brother, but he's a good actor, nevertheless. Alan Covert from Heavyweights and several of Sandler films. Rob Schneider, yes, this is where he says, "You can do it!" But of course, he even reprised his role as the townie in Little Nicky. But of course, he's also friends with Sandler and part of the Saturday Night Live cast. Kevin Farley, yes, the brother of Chris Farley, who at the time was no longer with us and still isn't. He always will be remembered. But Kevin Farley, yeah, he was in it. Frank Coraci, who not only directed the movie, because he also directed The Wedding Singer, he also had a role in the film as Roberto Borsche. Yeah, hard to believe that was him underneath him and all. Big Show, the WCW wrestler, Dan Fouts, Brent Musburger, Lynn Swan, Chris Fowler, Lee Corso, Trevor Miller, and all the rest. And it's written by, of course, Adam Sandler, along with Tim Herlihy, and it's directed by Frank Coraci. The movie begins set in Louisiana. We meet a man named Bobby Boucher. He's only 31 years old. He was played by Adam Sandler. He's a socially inept, but he also stutters a lot. And he becomes the water boy of the University of Louisiana's football program ever since he was a kid. But he lives with his overprotective mother, Helen, who's played by Kathy Bates. She always takes care of Bobby, trying to save himself from getting into bigger trouble. And and not only that, but she goes around playing with all the animals, like that donkey, and also winds up cooking all these snakes and squirrels, frog legs as a dessert, even barbecue some alligators. All come to mind. He also believes that his father, Robert Sr., you know, the husband of Helen's, as he died of dehydration in the Sierra while, you know, serving in the Peace Corps. Well, there is a twist at the end of the movie where we begin to learn that, well, he's alive all this time. So, yeah, he actually deserted them. Go figure. Well, anyway, as the football players constantly bullied Boucher, the Cougars' head coach, who's a complete asshole, named Red Bailu, played by Jerry Reed, fires Boucher, claiming that he's totally disrupted throughout the entire football team. Yeah, I mean, they started trashing him, teasing him, even sprayed water over his face. And tackle him, too. Yeah. Bunch of dicks. So because of that, Bobby approaches Coach Kine, who happens to be the assistant coach of Red, played by Henry Winkler. Yeah, you definitely feel bad for him, too, because he lost his manhood. He even lost his precious playbook. Yeah, the green book that he had all this time, ever since he was working with Red. Yeah, because now we know how stupid Red really is. Anyway, he signs the coach for South Central Louisiana State University called the Mud Dogs. And apparently he's being hired as the team's water boy. After all, he came by, you know, he was watching Coach Kine, you know, watching the football playoffs, and he's already hyperventilating, so he actually gave him a fresh, cold, high-quality H2O, yeah, water, to calm him down. And yes, he even serves it from a unsanitized pitcher. Yeah, go figure. Anyway, so we also learned that the Mud Dogs had lost 40 football consecutive games ever since 1994, The cheerleaders suddenly becomes alcoholics. Yeah, so they're not exactly as happy and cheery as they could be. Yeah, even the mascot, the mud dog, is drinking too. And the players are decided to force to share all their equipments due to budget cuts. So they're becoming complete losers. But then the new team, which including that complete asshole, which he actually calls Bobby Needle Dick later on, teases him, and Klein decided to encourage Bobby to stand up for himself. I mean, after all, he's been going back to flashbacks where he was a kid, you know, working for Red as a water boy, and he spotted John Elway. Yeah, he makes a cameo appearance, spit in his cooler. Just when he spotted the cross-eyed football player spitting in there as well. So, yeah. Yeah, he was about to beat John Elway up. But it never happened. And he just couldn't stand it anymore. So, because of that, he visualized an attack. The asshole. All the way and... and actually went all the way down. And yes, he even says, well, this is what a can of whoop-ass feels like. And Close Klein just says, son, you just opened a whole case of whoop-ass. We also had Farmer Fran, who's played by Blake Clark. Yeah, who mumbles a lot. We never understand the word he's saying, but hey, that's how he is. So, yes, he did repress anger issues just so he winds up visualizing and attacking, you know, the football player. But that what leads to what was going on. So now Coach Klein decided to hire Bobby not only as his team water boy, but also to become a football player for the Mud Dogs. So, yeah. But here's the problem. Helen refuses Bobby's potential when Klein meets with Helen while having some snake. Yes, because Helen does cook a lot of foods, all done by animals and reptiles and all of that. But tries to persuade her to let Bobby play on the team, but she refuses, saying that it's too dangerous. Yeah, she even calls it fool's ball. But yes, Klein convinced Bobby to play without letting her know, especially when he actually showed Bobby his Roy Orbison tattoo on his ass. Yeah. So this is where they try to get Bobby to play the feared linebacker. So now he's hired for the team after seeing the demonstration. I mean, at first, he couldn't remember the actual demo. He actually poked that one football player who's black in the eye until he begins to explain why that he got some anger issues. Well, yeah, because people started making fun of him. So this is where Klein tells him to visualize an attack, and then here we go. This is when he visualized Red. And this is where he screams. Okay, I know. I'm getting ahead of myself, but you know how it is. So yes, he now found fame. And then he also meets his childhood crush named Vicky Valancourt, who's played by Fairuza Balk. And yes, she's been in prison multiple times, but she also fixed Bobby's lawnmower. Yeah, because he does drive a lawnmower all the way. So he has a fast-speeding motor. So anyway, but things were not going so well for Bobby when he decided to invite Vicky to a barbecue. Because Helen refused to let Bobby hang around with her and fall in love. because of it. And that's why she calls her the devil. And Jezebel and all that. Yeah, because, well, she refers everyone as the devil. That's how she is. But anyway, the team's success earns a trip to the annual Bourbon Bowl to face the Cougars and Coach Bailu. It leads to all of this. I mean, at first, you know, Bobby had lost one game, but then again, they always lost every single game, and they're just getting tired of losing. But that was an accident, too, because, you know, one football player actually told Bobby about his mother that he accidentally gave the football to him, and he was ready to crush him. Yeah, just tackle and jump at him, but, yeah. I know, I mean, it sucks that that had to happen, but what can you do? But in the end, they finally won the victory. They actually had a party, and they just keep, having a pep rally, and they just kept on going ever since. But then, yes, the Cougar teams and Coach Brady Lou just came in, and, well, this is where we lead to what was going to happen to Bobby when he has to receive a letter from high school that, yeah, we learned that he never did finish high school at all. In fact, he never went to high school anyway because he's been homeschool all of his life. He only works as a water boy. So because of that, he was cut from the team. So now the rest of them had to play without him. Yeah, because they think he's a cheater. Yeah, go figure. I know I keep saying that a lot. But hey, Vicky actually stood for him, just grabbing a knife, trying to cut that asshole's head off. And then, of course, you see the townie, played by Rob Schneider, saying, "You can do it! You can do it! Cut his fucking head off!" So on and so forth. So because of that, he began to find out the truth. And that's when he decided to take a high school test in order for him to go back in the game to the Mud Dogs. But he got a 97, so that's cool, because he studied a lot. He had a fight with Helen because of all that. I mean, that causes Helen to wind up in the hospital because she had a broken heart. So Bobby had to stay with her for a while, trying to decorate the entire room exactly the way she loves it. Getting ready for New Year's, so that way they'll be ready for the game. So, yeah. So the entire crowd were there. They're trying to see what Bobby and Helen are doing, if they're okay. So by then, that's where we get to see the secrets behind what was going on with Helen. So Helen shows a photo album to Bobby to see why does she become so overprotective over the years. Yeah, we learned that her husband, Roberts, and that's the twist, where he actually deserted them, so he didn't die of a peace corps at all. And that just brought in a lot of bad memories, and he thought that she was afraid she was going to lose Bobby too if this was going to happen, so she'll be all alone. Lonely. So that's why. But in the end, she learned her lesson. She understands. So now Bobby can finally play the game again. And that's when they're getting ready for the Bourbon Bowl. And they're actually winning pretty strongly, too, as it goes on. With Vicky just filling in for Bobby's water boy duties. Yeah, just pouring in all the water. Even Helen decided to join in as well. Just pouring some coffee for the cheerleaders, so that way they won't end up getting know, too sober. So everything was going great. So, and after that, they won the victory, and now both Bobby and Bicky are married. Until Robert, yeah, which he changed his name to Roberto, stops by. And yes, even Helen decided to tackle him like Bobby does. And then there you go. The movie ends. So they're just getting ready for their honeymoon. So, yeah, I mean, it's what it is. It's a fun comedy. Hilarious. Never get tired of it. So. In fact, I remember watching this movie hundreds of times, especially with my late Aunt Bertha. Yeah, God rest her soul. She started to love Adam Sandler. I mean, every time we watch an Adam Sandler comedy, she always crackles with a smile, and she always actually copies what Helen says. Brink Franklin is the devil! Little girls are the devil! Yeah, that was sweet. God, do I miss her so much. But anyway, yeah, I mean, it's what it is. I mean, it's not an Oscar-winning performance here, okay? But Kathy Bates did a fine job playing the role. In fact, this might... And yeah, this is the performance that I really appreciated. I mean, after playing the Andy Welks in Misery, Adam Sandler was hilarious in the movie as Bobby Boucher, so I didn't have a problem with that. That was the whole point. I mean, he's playing a stuttered guy who's been bullied a lot, but he works as a water boy, you know, bringing in some very high-quality H2O, you know, such as purified, that they kept some nice clean water in the canteen. There was even a one moment where he actually brought in that one cooler that actually came from Alaska, and the fact that it's always cold. So this was like a gift. So I love that. Fairuza Balk was totally sexy in this movie. Stunningly sexy as Vicky Valancourt. I mean, Henry Winkler was fun to watch. Yeah, even though you feel bad for him, but at this point on, at least he's becoming stronger now. But I know that's how he feels. Jerry Reed, the asshole coach, fine performance. Even Clint Howard was fun too. I mean, it was great to see him in the movie where. There was even that one joke where he was with his friend. It was that ugly buck teeth. Yeah, so he's... he even explains that that Bobby Boucher was the best linebacker since Joe Montana. And then his friend says, Joe Montana was that quarterback, you idiot. And then at the end he says, I said Joe Montana! That's right, Joe Mantegna, Mia's father, the actor. But that was a funny joke. And I love the moment when Bobby suddenly went straight at the teacher, who looks like Colonel Sanders, because he was explaining about the alligators, you know, that they have medulla oblongata. Yeah, because that's where... anger, jealousy, and aggression came from. I mean, yes, he really berated him by actually having to explain what Mama says. And this is where, you know, he just got so intense that he actually tackles the teacher. And yeah, it was a bit of a running joke, too, because he always gets tackled a lot, too. I mean, look at his eyes, too. It's like he had two black eyes and he has a broken arm. On top of that, he's afraid of him, too. Oh, yeah, that was hilarious. There's also two hot chicks. who were almost about to flirt on Bobby as well, but of course Bobby's just explained, you know, that, you know, he was hired to become the linebacker, and the fact that he already has a girlfriend named Vicky, and he just explains about, you know, he was chosen because of Coach, the fact that he was chosen because of Coach Klein and Helen. Yeah. Oh, you get it. And yes, there's even a scene where Vicky actually shows Bobby her boobies. Yeah, after his first kiss. Yeah, you get the idea. Bobby even helps Coach Klein to actually visualize an attack too. Well, he visualized in a whole different way to Red, yeah, pretending that he was a baby, and so he makes fun of him, or even a puppy. And of course, he does visualize an attack by actually spotting all of the people who made fun of him. So this is why he keeps, you know, tackling all the football players around. There's even a scene where, yeah, one football player, a black one, yeah, with the buck-tooth teeth, and he has the bandana. Yeah, he even visualized attack. Oh, you're going to love this. A KKK member. And he kicks the football. And you begin to hear him screaming. I know. I had to mention that. Sorry. But it has a lot of cameos in the movie, most of which are from ESPN, ABC, all of which are owned by Disney. Yeah, Touchstone Pictures released this film, so it makes sense. I mean, they couldn't get any other company to sponsor, or any station. That explains why they show Sports Center. They also have a great soundtrack, too. A lot of great music. I mean, Lenny Kravitz, as well as Rush, Quest and Clearwater Rival, CCR, Goldfinger, The Doors, Earth, Wind & Fire, The Allman Brothers Band, John Mellencamp, yeah, John Cougar Mellencamp. So, great soundtrack, too. I know critics panned this movie, including Siskel and Ebert. They're even bitching and complaining about it. What'd you expect? I mean, they even criticize, you know, Adam Sandler's performance, you know, where he stutters a lot, saying about his speech impediment and all that, saying his voice is supposed to be funny or anything, but I'm sorry. And the fact that they say that his character is as irritating as nails on a chalkboard. See, that's why I don't trust the critics these days, because they always like to criticize everyone's work. But then again, I'm a film reviewer and I do criticize what I think about a movie that I watch. So what can you do? I know. I've always been bitching on the critics these days, you know, how I'm not trusting them or anything like that. Hey, don't get me wrong, okay? I don't hate them. It's just that sometimes, you know, they just don't appreciate it or they just don't get it. And that's why we're dealing with this shit every fucking time. Because, well, this is why people go to Rotten Tomatoes all the time, just to see the score that the film have gotten. And people just feel like we were idiots. Like they're talking down to us. Yeah, like we're the minorities. And of course, we are the minorities. Or the majorities, even. I mean, that's, you know, we're different from everyone else. But hey, comedies are subjected, so what can you... Just as dramas, animation, action films... You guessed it, they're always subjective. But what can you do? What can you do? Also to note that there's a YouTuber named Adam DeRue, you know, who does all these filming locations everywhere he goes and trying to spot every location of every single movie that's been filmed over there. Not to mention a TV show as well. Yes, he actually makes an appearance in one of the stands while they're doing all the football scenes in the movie. So if you spotted him, well, you'll be lucky, but it goes pretty fast. I mean, this is a fast-paced comedy, only 89 minutes. So he'll explain it on one of his videos. But he's a cool guy. But hey, that's the idea. I mean, it's an anti-bullying type in a way, but it's also a hilarious, fun football comedy, even if you're not a big fan of sports. Yeah, I used to be, but not anymore. You know, just for a good, dumb, fun comedy, I would watch this anytime. I watched this many times. I would just never get tired of it. And I'm just happy that at least I got the Blu-ray to appreciate. So. And it's better than all the later Sandler films I've seen. But whatever. Anyway, that's The Waterboy, and I give the movie, what else? 4 stars. I'm going to keep it that way. My trusty water. I'm Joseph A. Sobora, and I'll see you later. Bye.